In our previous video, we saw how difficult it is to share out resources in the 5G network and how researchers at the University of Exeter are using machine learning to tackle this problem. In this video, we'll look at a different application of machine learning in their research, this time for running a digital twin of the 5G network. So, what is a digital twin? It's usually a virtual replica of a physical object or system, such as an aeroplane or a building. It's like a really complex computer model, which uses the live data from the actual system. This would be really useful for 5G networks. A digital twin could help network operators test out new products and services before releasing them onto the real network. Or they could use the digital twin to monitor different parts of the network using the live data. But there are two main problems that make a network digital twin really difficult to design. Firstly, the network isn't just made of physical stuff, like cell towers, servers, and routers. It also contains lots of virtual components, like network slices, virtual nodes, and connections. Also, the virtual components are constantly being changed, created, and destroyed. You might have a network slice which is set up just for a sports event, and then it's deleted afterwards. This will be going on at different times all across the network, so it's really hard to keep track of everything and how they're all connected together. Luckily, machine learning is great for dealing with complex systems just like this. Let's find out from the University of Exeter academics, Dr. Yulei Wu and Dr. Haozhe Wang, how machine learning can help make a network digital twin. Yulei, good to speak to you again. Could you tell us a bit more about how you're using machine learning to design the network digital twin?
Yes, sure. We spoke last time about deep learning. Deep learning can help with the building of the network digital twin by modeling and learning from the complex network data, detecting defective devices, and evaluating and predicting the performance. In this work, we are using a type of deep learning technique, which is called graph neural network, to identify the connections between virtual network slices, servers, and the physical infrastructure.
Haozhe, can you tell us a bit more about graph neural networks?
Yes, a graph neural network is a type of deep learning frameworks that can handle the data represented in the form of graphs, like in social networks, molecules, or the telecommunication network in our case. So a graph of the network not only contains all those nodes, such as base stations, network routers, and servers in a cloud data center, but also the connections between them. A digital twin of the entire telecommunication network would be far too complex. So instead, it's more practical that the network will be made of smaller digital twins for different components that all connect together. And our work here is focused on the digital twin for network slicing. The digital twin for network slices can be used to make connections more effective across the whole network, or we say from end to end, and make management of the network slices more intelligent and more cost effective.
Yulei, I guess this is still the early stages of this research. What are the next steps?
Yes, it's still an early stage. So for the next step, first, extending and incorporating multiple network digital twins for more network components so that it can represent the entire network. We also hope this can help influence the design of other network digital twins or digital twins for other areas of the network. It will take the collective effort of many different research groups working with industry to make improvements to the network over a number of years. But maybe one day we will have a holographic digital twin to run the network or future network or beyond 5G network.
So digital twins are a pretty new concept for the 5G and beyond 5G networks, but they could be really useful for network operators to help them run the network more effectively so that we all have a reliable service and so do the other smart devices that are also connected to the network. We hope you've learned a little bit more about network digital twins and some of the cutting edge research in this area. To find out more, click on the link in the description and follow us on social media for updates from the Exeter Science Centre.